हेलो गाइस, दिस इज रेवन फ्रॉम डीजी इंटीग्रिटी। वेलकम टू टेक न्यूज एपिसोड 89। सोशल मीडिया जॉइंस लाइक फेसबुक, ट्विटर, व्हाट्सएप एंड इंस्टाग्राम में फेस बैन इन इंडिया इफ दे फेल टू कंप्लाई विद द न्यू इंटरमीडियरी गाइडलाइंस फॉर सोशल मीडिया प्लेटफॉर्म। द 3 months डेडलाइन गिवन बाय द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स एंड इन्फॉर्मेशन टेक्नोलॉजी टू एक्सेप्ट दीज गाइडलाइंस एंड्स टुडे May 25th, बट नन ऑफ द जॉइंस हैव सो फार एक्सेप्टेड द न्यू गाइडलाइंस। द रूल्स विल बी इफेक्टिव फ्रॉम टुमारो डिस्पाइट दीज कंपनीज सीकिंग अ टोटल 6 months डिले इन देयर इंप्लीमेंटेशन। होम ग्रोन सोशल मीडिया प्लेटफॉर्म कू, विच इज द इंडियन वर्जन ऑफ ट्विटर, इज द ओनली प्लेटफॉर्म that has so far accepted the center's intermediary guidelines. WhatsApp says that it will not limit any functionality to users not accepting the new privacy policies. This comes after Ministry of Electronics and Information Technology gave WhatsApp 7 days to respond to its letter on May 18th. However, WhatsApp will continue to push notifications to users to accept the new privacy policy. Battlegrounds Mobile India may have the APK file of the same size as PUBG Mobile's. PUBG Mobile APK file is around 600 MB, so could be the Battlegrounds Mobile. Battlegrounds Mobile India will be supported on devices running Android 5.1.1 or higher. Call of Duty Mobile Season 4 has started rolling out a new update for players. The new season, named Spurned and Burned, introduced a Wild West theme to the popular Battle Royale mobile game. Call of Duty's new update is now live and users should soon see it pop up on the Google Play Store or Apple App Store. New changes to Season 4 include a new 1-to-1 duel mode, an updated multiplayer mode, a Capture the Gold mode, and a new map for the popular PC and console title Call of Duty Modern Warfare 3. There are 2 new weapons too, including the Holder 26 Mythic version and an MK2 marksman rifle. OnePlus co-founder Carl Pei's Twitter account has been hacked. The attackers tweeted that nothing has entered a crypto space with nothing coin. Tweet has been now deleted and the account has been retrieved. Deezo brand announced under Realme Tech Live. The brand will focus on smart entertainment, smart home, smart care and accessories. Realme will back Deezo in industrial design, supply chain and all IoT experience. Apple today announced that its Worldwide Developers Conference was started on June 7th. The event will conclude 3 days later on June 10th. As with last year, the conference will be entirely online. As usual, the first day is the busiest, as that when the company also holds its keynote, where it will announce upcoming developments to iOS, iPadOS, macOS, watchOS and tvOS. There may also have some hardware announcements in it. Apple is gearing up for the Worldwide Developer Conference 2021. The company is expected to unveil iOS 15, iPadOS 15 and macOS 12, etc. Apple is also expected to unveil a new MacBook Pro alongside head of the annual developer event. The new details of another Mac devices have been leaked online. There is a leak that Apple One X Mac Mini design renders. The renders reveal that Apple's upcoming compact desktop computer is getting a redesign this year. The new Mac Mini will also draw power by M1X chip, rumored with a launch later this year. The new design renders of the Mac Mini, and the Apple will redesign its compact desktop. The Mac Mini is getting smaller in size. It will have 4 Thunderbolt USB Type-C port and 2 Type-A ports. The compact Mac will also have a Ethernet and HDMI ports, unlike the upcoming MacBook Pro. The Mini will not have an SD card slot, according to the leaks. Realme GT Neo Flash Edition and Realme Q3 Pro Carnival Edition has been launched in China. Realme GT Neo Flash Edition touts a 65W fast charging support, and it comes with a 6.43-inch Full HD Plus AMOLED display and a 120Hz display screen. It also has a MediaTek Dimensity 1200 chipset, and it comes with a 64MP triple rear cameras. Realme Q3 Pro Carnival Edition comes with a Snapdragon 768G chipset. It comes with a 6.43-inch Full HD Plus AMOLED display with a 120Hz refresh rate. It also has a 64MP triple rear camera and a 4500mAh battery with 50W fast charging. Qualcomm has announced a refreshed version of its Snapdragon 7C compute platform for laptops. Snapdragon 7C Generation 2, the new chipset from Qualcomm, is aimed at entry-level Windows PCs and Chromebooks. Microsoft and Qualcomm are teaming up to bring the Snapdragon Developer Kit, meant to give developers a cheaper option to optimize their Windows application for the ARM64 instruction set. The Snapdragon Developer Kit is built around a 8nm Snapdragon 7C platform, complete with a AX15 LTE modem, an octa-core Cairo 468 processor and up to Quad HD at 60Hz display support. Next PlayStation restock in India is arriving on May 27. Shop at SC has revealed the next PS5 pre-order and delivery dates. The wider PS5 Digital Edition available can be expected. MI 11 Lite India launch has been teased by the company. The handset launched globally back in March. MI 11 Lite is the company's slimmest phone in 2021. Though the phone comes in both 4G and 5G models, we can expect only the 4G model might find its way to the Indian market. MI 11 Lite specifications include a 6.55 inch display, Snapdragon 732G processor and a 64 megapixel primary camera. Xiaomi has just published a new patent. This patent was for a flexible screen module, with its highlight feature being that it is nearly 100% screen-to-body ratio. This display technology also includes a two regions or two display areas along with a hinge mechanism. In the sub-area of the second display region, this device houses a camera module. The camera system moves along with a hinge mechanism. Through this movement, the second display of this device can be used as a regular front display and can even uncover the cameras for rear photography as well. OnePlus could launch the Note 2 very soon. Ahead of the upcoming launch, the company accidentally listed the devices on its website. OnePlus UK might have accidentally revealed the name. The Note successor, the Note 2, was listed alongside other smartphones that have already launched worldwide. Before the company could remove the name, Android police managed to grab a screenshot. The device is expected to launch soon in India. According to the recent report, one of the two devices is launching on June 10th. This could well be the Note 2. It is rumored to launch with the MediaTek Dimensity 1200 processor under the hood. Samsung Galaxy Tab S7 Fan Edition 5G has been officially launched. The key specifications include a 12.4-inch WQGA TFT LCD screen, Qualcomm Snapdragon 750G processor, and it comes with a 10,090 mAh battery. It comes on an Android 11-based One UI 3.1 custom skin and a 128GB native storage. The price could be around 57,800 Indian rupees for the 4GB RAM and a 64GB storage version, but the price for 6GB RAM and 128GB model is not clear at this moment. This tablet comes in black and silver color and it is currently listed on Samsung Germany website. Samsung Galaxy M32 was recently spotted on Bluetooth SIG and Wi-Fi Alliance certification websites. Samsung Galaxy M32 key specifications are expected to include MediaTek Helio G80 processor, and it runs on Android 11 as its OS, and it will have a 6000 mAh battery. The official launch announcement from the handset will be made really soon. There have been a number of rumors and reports regarding the upcoming Google Pixel 6 series. One of the notable rumors is that the device will feature a custom chipset and it will build on collaboration with Samsung. Now, a new leak is revealed that the chip will offer a performance similar to Qualcomm Snapdragon 870 processor. The new custom chip in the Pixel 6 series is codenamed as Whitechapel, will reveal the Snapdragon 870 chipset. Notably, this marks a major shift for the search engine giant that has always shipped its devices with Qualcomm processor. Harmony OS will soon be arriving to Hawaii's lineup of devices as the company rebrands EMUI. The new OS will debut during a livestream event held by Hawaii on June 2nd at 8 PM local time, where it will be officially announced a new operating system. Lenovo announced multiple products at its second summer product launch. The lineup includes new tablets, one of which is a Xeoxin Pad Plus, a mid-range tablet that offers a lot of pretty affordable price. The Xeoxin Pad Plus has a 11-inch LCD 2K display with moderate side bezels of equal thickness on all sides. There is an 8-megapixel ToF sensor in front with the support of face unlock, as the tablet doesn't have a fingerprint scanner. On the back, there are 13-megapixel autofocus camera and a LED flash. This tablet is powered by a Snapdragon 750G processor and comes with a 6GB of RAM and 128GB of storage. You get 110GB when you boot it up for the first time, but there is a microSD card slot to add more storage if you want. Lenovo ships it with a ZUI 12.5 based on Android 11, and it comes with March 2021 security patch. There is a 7700 mAh battery inside the device, and it has a support for quick charge 3.0. The tablet charges via Type-C 3.1 port and also via 4 Pogo pins at the bottom with a landscape mode. Xeoxin Pad Pro 2021 is a premium tablet that packs a lot of impressive specifications and features in an aviation-grade aluminium alloy body that is just 5.8 mm thick. It is available in a single color variant, silver with a two-tone finish. Xeoxin Pad Pro 2021 has 11.5-inch OLED screen with a 90Hz refresh rate with a 2K resolution. The display has a 16:10 aspect ratio, and it runs on a Qualcomm Snapdragon 870 processor. Power this tablet along with a 6GB of LPDDR5 RAM and a 128GB of UFS 3.1 storage. Just like the Xeoxin Pad Plus, there is a microSD card slot for storage expansion. It packs with an immersive 8600 mAh battery with a support for quick charge 3.0 and a 20 watt fast charging. It has 4 JBL speakers, Dolby Atmos, dual band Wi-Fi and a Bluetooth 5.1. There is a USB Type-C 3.1 port and a 4 POCO pins for charging and for connecting it to the optional keyboard cover. Xiaomi-owned Android Skin MIUI is known for offering a security app that includes features like Speed Booster, WhatsApp Cleaner, Cleaner and a lot more. The developers have revamped the application with the rollout of MIUI 10. However, now it seems that the company has reduced animation on low-end devices with the MIUI 12. With the new security update, Xiaomi has decided to ditch the animation with the new version of the security application. Xiaomi UI shared some screenshots of the new update revealing the new changes. The smartphone in the list includes the Redmi Note 8, Redmi 9, Redmi 9T and Redmi 9 Power and many more phones. It seems that the company has decided to make the application similar and deliver a better user experience as the low-end smartphones might face difficulty in running these animations. Thanks for watching this video. Please kindly support my channel by giving a like, share and subscribe. And follow Digi Integrity on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook.